welcome the supremo of love. Yes, it's Ray Foley!
Gentlemen, welcome to Take Me Out, the dating show for the 21st century. This is the penultimate show in our series, so it's a bit like half an hour before the nightclub ends. So, who knows, maybe we'll have a couple of catfights among our girls as they try to secure a guy. It's time to meet our very own pussycat dolls. Let's bring on the girls! Okay, hello, lovely ladies. Oh, that's music to my ears. Arlene, what kind of guys are the kind of guys you've left your lights on for?
Nice dress sense, seem to be kind of a bit cheeky, but not cheesy either. But they have like a nice bit of a sense of humour.
Okay.
I've been okay with the height thing. I don't mind. I'm kind of only 5'2".
You're
anyway,
dinky.
So,
you're a miniature human. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
In a good way. Yeah. You're lovely. You're just small and petite.
I have my gnome hat here beside me.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. All right, Arlene. I'll find you a man tonight. And Orla, your light's still on as well. What are you looking for?
At this stage, I'm mad for a lad. I don't care what I get. I'll get one.
She's mad for a lad. They're all mad for lads. It's our girls, everybody. Okay, girls. Here's how it works. Each girl has a light on in front of them. When our boy comes through that door, he'll have 3 chances to impress. If they like what they see, they'll keep their lights turned on. If they don't like what they see, they'll turn off their lights. Now, for example, girls, if I was to say, I'm not really a people person. If I was to say, my favourite meal is liver with fava beans and a nice Chianti. Before I finally reveal, I'm Hannibal Lecter. But it's a blackout. And our boy goes back home to his mammy. That's how it works. Now, lights back on, ladies. OK, girls, it's time to play for real. Are you ready for your first man? I like the sound of that. Don't forget, listen to the music the guys walk onto because they've chosen it for themselves. And it's time, if you're ready, to bring on the boys! To the show, sir. They're all yours. Knock 'em dead.
How you doing, ladies? My name's Seán, and I'm from Artain in Dublin.
Seán from Dublin. But girls, are you turned on or turned off? Not a single light turned off. You've got the magic, Seán. You've got the magic. Let's get out there and have a talk to a couple of our ladies and see what it is that's so special about you. Fire.
Well, nice dress sense. Yeah, I like a man who dresses well. So, yeah, that ticks one box anyway. So.
Thanks very much.
Yeah.
Sarah Jane likes what she sees.
I really do, yeah. It really looks like you work out in the gym, yeah?
I've been out to do it 2 days, yeah.
You were quite hopeful last week.
I was really hopeful.
Yeah, we had our guys there. You left your light on for them. You fancied 2 of them.
Yeah, I really did. Yeah, yeah, I'm really liking their style and everything.
Tracy, how about you?
He is all that and a bag of chips.
Maybe after your date tonight, he'll buy you a bag of chips.
Maybe.
Maybe. Chips.
Let's have a chat over here with a couple of our ladies. Mairead, your light is still on as well.
Well, I'm from Kerry and I travel the world for you.
Okay. Mairead's going to be spending a lot of money on petrol. Okay. Seán, you're still in the game, and take a look at this. Girls, would you jump them or would you dump them?
I like to try new things every day, and the strong man really pushes you to your limit. So I'd like to get with somebody who can push me to the limit. Some of my previous girlfriends have done strong man and been into the fitness, but all shapes and sizes do for me. My daily routine involves me eating 7 or 8 times a day, so I have to fit my fitness in around that. And my strongman on the weekends takes up one of my mornings, so I have plenty of time to party hard with the lads and with the women.
Seán. 28 girls still left and one more chance to impress our ladies. You have 30 seconds to do that. Knock their socks off in the next 30 seconds as you get flirty for 30. And ladies, if you're feeling nothing, hit that button.
Okay, ladies, as you can see from the video, I like to keep fit. But besides that, I'm an electrical engineer and I hope to own my own business in the next couple of years. The type of girl I'm looking for tonight has to laugh at my stupid jokes, not take herself too seriously, and be up for a good date when we go out for a date. If you think you're the whore, leave on your light and we never know. Sparks might be flying tonight.
Samantha was the first girl we lost in that round, and she lost it at just the point where you said she has to be able to laugh at your stupid jokes. Give us a stupid joke then, as soon as she gets on.
You put me on the spot, Ray. What is the weirdest animal in the jungle?
Don't know.
An octopus.
It's pretty weird. It's pretty weird. But she didn't laugh. It's a good thing she's out. Lol.
Yeah, I'm liking it. Really? Yeah. It's good to see that you listen to us from time to time and
you've
got it here now.
Very occasionally listen to you.
The sparks will be flying later on. Ah.
Sarah Jane, did he say anything in that round that turned you off?
Round 1, 2, 3, total knockout.
Oh! Ding, ding, ding. Okay, Seán, you've got 24 girls still remaining in our final round. That means you'll definitely get a date tonight. Yeah! Now, Sarah, the power is in your hands. You have to whittle it down to just 2 girls. Out of all these lights on in front of you, you have to turn a load of them off and leave the final 2 remaining for our final round. It's time to whittle, sir. Who should he go for? Who should he turn off? Who should he leave on the audience? What do you think? He's got so many lights to get rid of. 20 girls still to go. Seán, I'll give you a hand over here. I'll give you a hand. Aoife, yes or no? Quick.
No.
No. Gone?
Gone.
Gone.
Oh.
Helen?
It's okay.
Keep. Lorraine?
Gone.
Go on. Lol. What do you think? Audience, give us a hand. Okay. We need to leave 2 lights on. Who do you go for? 8 more lights to go, man. Come on. Who do you want to get rid of? Holly, Latanya's still there as well. You need to get it down to 2, man. Come on. 3 more lights to go. Get rid of 3. Adam's gone. Lorna, Tracy and Sarah Jane all still in the convenience. All right, Sarah Jane's still in. Get back here, give a round of applause, everybody. You are so dead. All right, we've got 2 girls left, but you can only take 1 out. It's your turn to find out something about them. 1 question and 1 question only, Seán.
Okay, girls, I love my junk food, but what I want to know is, if I was a Cadbury's cream egg, how would you eat me?
Okay, Lorna.
Okay, I'll keep it short and simple. Slowly.
And Holly?
Take the wrapper off slowly, then eat it to enjoy it more.
Okay, so it's between slowly and stripping off, and one of our girls I need to tell you that one of our girls can pick up things with her toes. One of our girls can pick up things with her toes. Get out there, Seán, and turn one off and take one out. Who should he go for, audience?
Let me see your toes. Let me see your toes.
Get started anyway, don't you? You happy, Seán?
She's gorgeous.
Good stuff. And Lorna?
Yep.
And I can tell you that the girl who can pick up things with her toes is Holly. Okay, lads, let me tell you, you're going to be treated like celebrities tonight where you're going. There's always someone trying to take a photo up your skirt in.
I went for Lauren in the end because she's gorgeous, and on the way out she caught my eye, so I decided to leave her light on to last.
I left my light on for Seán pretty much. He's a good looking guy, come out great dress sense, seems to be ambitious, so just have to see how the date goes now.
Yes! Last time on Take Me Out, Eleanor went on a date with Paulie. Did they hit it off? Let's find out.
When I first met Paul, I thought that he was a really nice, caring, which is what I go for in a fella guy.
How are you?
How are you?
Good.
He seemed a bit bonkers and balubas and nuts, and it's a bit like myself. I don't know, will I be able to tame this fella?
When I met Eleanor, I thought she was very attractive. And exactly what I look for, a smile, blonde.
I got a shock when he said stripper.
Stripping, yeah.
Yeah?
Like hen parties or 21st and all that.
So I just thought we'll have the crack, and I taught him the dance from Pulp Fiction. Paul is my type. He's got lovely blue eyes. He's got a great smile.
Top date, top girl. Definitely gonna see her again.
They got on like a house on fire. Okay, that coffee isn't gonna percolate itself, so we'll be right back after this break. Welcome back. In part one, we saw Seán take Lorna out. But that means we get to welcome a new girl. Everyone say hello to Andrea! Yeah. Andrea, welcome to the show.
Hi, Foley. How are you?
I'm fine, missus. What are you looking for in a man? What can I do for you tonight?
I'm looking for an Italian stallion.
An Italian stallion? All right. Do they actually have to be Italian?
No.
OK. As long as it's a stallion, though, it's fine. OK, we'll see if we can drag a horse down through that lift. And we'll see how we get on. Give it up for Andrea, everybody. Let's lift that latch and bring on the boy! Welcome to the show, sir. They are all yours. Take it away.
Hi, ladies. I'm Michael, and I'm from Longford.
Michael from Longford. The question is, girls, are you turned on or turned off? Oh. Oh, three lights off. That's a pretty good result. 27 girls still interested. Let's go and have a chat with a couple of the girls who turned off their lights. Helen.
I know I said I wanted to keep it country, but he's a bit too country. Sorry. He's lovely, though. You're
okay.
Nice.
What can I say? Country is country.
Country is country. At least it's the right country. What's wrong with his shirt? What's wrong with it? It's what? What's wrong with his shirt?
A little bit farmery. I'm sorry. Sorry.
Now, I know Edel is actually looking for a farmer.
Getting a little bit excited here. Did you just find me like Jack sucked in Ray?
Oh, really?
maybe. We'll see.
You're still interested anyway?
Still interested at the moment, yeah.
Okay, and we'll see how he gets on in the next round. All right, Michael, you have 27 girls still interested in you. 27 beautiful women still with their lights on, but will they still be on at the end of round two? Off you go and get changed. Give it up for Michael, everybody. And the question is, will those lights stay on after this? Girls, remember, if you think he's Mr. Right, leave on that light and give a welcome back to Michael. Of our girls are still interested. Let's see what it was they didn't like. Aoife, you were the one girl who said that she wanted a guy who was into his football. I deliver and you turn off your light. What's going on?
I like a guy who's into his football, but I don't want a guy who's like to date a footballer guy. They'd have more time to play football and when are you going to spend the time with me?
That's fair. Oh, okay, fair enough. Faya, you turned off your light. Why?
Well, it looked like to me that he couldn't handle the ball very well, so I don't think you'd handle me too well. I'm a bit of a wild girl.
Oh. OK, let's get some good news. Mairead, your light is still on. You like what you see?
I do. Was there football in that?
Yeah. There was a football, the whole bit with the kicking around the ball. You missed that, yeah?
No. No, I didn't see that at all, at all, at all. I'm digging the farmer's tan, by the way. He's a fella now I'd be proud to bring home to Mammy and Daddy.
Yes. Michael, you have 14 girls left, still in the game for our third and final round. You've got 30 seconds to impress those remaining 14 ladies. 30 seconds to get flirty. It's flirty for 30. And girls, if you want to get physical, keep that light visible.
Right, girls, I love all my sports, especially soccer. I play soccer for a living. I've been pro now for 3 years, and it's a big part of my life. Girl I'd go out with wouldn't necessarily have to be a soccer lover, but I would love her to come to the odd game and cheer me on from the sidelines. I love a good night out in the town, and I'm not afraid to go on the dance floor, so I would love a girl that does like to move. My life is pretty good at the minute, but I think I'm just missing one thing. That's that special girl in my life, and hopefully I can find her tonight in the show.
Oh! Yes! Eight gone, but six remaining, and that means you've got a date!
Yes!
Now the power is in your hands. Well done. You have to whittle it down to just two girls. Get out there, knock off all the lights except the two you would most like to take out on a date tonight. Audience, give your answer. Who should we go for? Sarah Jane, Natanya, Karen, Ella, Ray, or Minerva. Go on. Give them a hand, everybody. Who should he turn off? Michael. Okay, it's between Orla and Ray. Come on, audience, give him a hand. Orla is gone, Mairead is still in. Okay, two, one more to go. Natanya, Sarah Jane. Looking good. Come on, dude.
Sorry.
That is harsh. Back here, give him a round of applause. You are mincemeat. Harsh but fair. Okay, there's only two girls left and there can be only one. So this is where you get to ask our girls a question. Natanya and Mairead, still in the game. One question between the two of them. And depending on how they answer, you decide on who you're taking out tonight. Away you go, Michael.
I really love fancy dress, especially Halloween, and I love dressing up. So if you were coming out with me on a night, fancy dress, what would you wear and why?
Okay, fancy dress, playing dress up. Natanya, your answer.
Since you're a football player, I think I'll have to dress up as your little cheerleader and cheer you on.
Hey! Sounds good. And Mairead.
I go as the Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland because I'm a bit mad in the head and I can be your fantasy.
Ah, okay. So it's pom-poms or headgear, Michael. That's your choice. I don't envy you. And before you make that choice, I need to tell you that one of our girls likes to climb poles. Okay? Get out there and turn one off and take one out. Audience, give him a hand. Who should he go for? Between Natalia and Mairead. Who should he take out tonight? Natalia or Mairead? It's between the two of them. What do you think? I'm sorry.
You're okay, it's okay.
It's such a tease. Dude, we need a date tonight. Mairead and Michael, you two finally going on a date. Guys, are you happy? First of all, Mairead, are you happy you're going out with Michael?
I'm bloody delighted.
All right. And I can reveal that Mairead is the girl who likes to climb poles.
ESP
poles. Oh, okay. That explains. Fair enough. All right, guys, for your date tonight, we're sending you somewhere you'll be treated like royalty. Well, sort of. Instead of your head on a stamp, you'll get your head stamped in the car park at Shifters! Off you go!
That was brilliant, Clark,
that was
wasn't it?
Brilliant.
Serious, oh my Clark.
God.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, to be honest, it was taking the top off that really did it for me. But after talking to him just coming down the aisle, he's a lovely bloke, sweetest eyes, and I think this guy could be a keeper.
It was actually a really hard decision in the end, I have to say, because I kept just going over and back and over and back, but I just went over and I looked at her eyes and she looked back and there was, I don't know, kind of a small bit of a connection or something, so I'm really hoping the day goes well.
Good one. All right, after the break, we're going to do it all again. We'll be right back. You're welcome back. I've already matched Michael and Mairead, and that means we have a new girl. Say hello, everybody, to Sandra. Hey, Sandra.
Hi, Ray. How are you?
I'm great. It's always nice to welcome a new girl to the show.
Thank you.
Sandra, what are you looking for?
I suppose, like everybody, I'm looking for just a great guy.
Yeah.
So, somebody really nice, somebody who's genuinely great. I don't know what qualifies being great in 2010, but mm-hmm. just a really great guy. Someone who's not afraid of the kitchen,
okay.
or not afraid of the garden,
right.
or the dance floor. I didn't mention the bedroom. But
let's keep it clean.
Just an all-rounder.
Okay, good stuff. Give it up for Sandra, everybody. I'll see if I can sort you out for a date tonight, Sandra. It's time to meet our next man. Ladies, are you ready? Let's do this thing. Release the hound and bring on the boy! Welcome to the show, sir. They are all yours. Knock 'em dead.
Hi, my name is Dave and I'm from Roscommon.
Dave from Roscommon! Well, ladies, are you turned on or turned off? Okay, still in the 20s. Eight
Sorry.
Gone, but 22 remaining. That is a result. Well done, sir. Latanya.
Yes, he's too close to home. Again, I'm from Athlone, so...
Right, okay.
Just kind of trying to get away from that. Don't be smart with me now this time either.
Well, you've used up all the natural resources. That's what I'm doing.
I'm the other side of Roscommon, though. I'm not that lonely.
Doesn't matter.
Still too close to home. Yeah.
Right.
There's only a couple of counties left for Latanya. You have to realise that.
Fair enough.
I know Minerva likes her boys tall, and I think I may have delivered.
Yes, you have. Love the height, love everything, love the walk in, the entrance. Can't complain there.
Yeah, and first song, you like that?
I did.
Ladies, you liked it?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Jen, you like what you see?
Yeah, right, you really changed me on this year. I'm actually starting to go past looks. I say you're a lovely fella, so I'm going to give you a try. No, I don't mean it that bad. I don't mean it like that. I mean, what I'm looking for, like, it's something that I wouldn't normally go for. I meant like that, so I'm starting to look past what I'd normally...
I understand.
Yeah, just walk away.
Jen,
right?
It's OK, drop it. He gets the point. OK, David, you've got 22 girls still remaining, 22 lights still on, and that is a fantastic result at the end of our first round. Heading into round two, you've got 30 seconds to impress our ladies. It's flirty for 30, and girls, if you think he's a mug, then pull that plug.
All right, girls, as you know, I'm from Roscommon, but I'm not your typical country boy. I've been travelling for the last 2 years, and I worked in Dublin for 3 years before that. I work in sales, so some people say I have the gift of the gab, but I just think it's good to talk. I go for girls who are funny, sexy, a little bit quirky, and aren't afraid to speak their mind. So if that's you, leave your light on, and hopefully I can take you out later on.
Oh! Yes, high five. Hold on, dude. Not a single light off in that round. With 22 lights still remaining, you've a lot riding on this final round. One more chance for our girls to turn off their lights. You're going to sing a little tune for them. I've heard it. It's brilliant. And remember, ladies, if you're feeling nothing, push that button.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Street lights, people.
David, what a performance. That means you've got a date! Nice one. We have 12 girls remaining. Jen, you knocked off your light there. Why?
I forgot it was a light. I thought it was a stop button. I'm really sorry, but you butchered that song. It's one of my songs I like to dance to, but there was no oomph, and I was like to pick it up and shake it and give it more. Like, I'm really sorry. Good effort, though.
OK.
Cheers.
Ali, your light is still on as well. Yeah, nothing about that song turned you off.
Well, no, I was jamming along with it, and that song is just a song you can't take too seriously. If you try too hard in that, then you have to laugh at yourself.
Yeah.
I find that really attractive.
I was trying pretty hard, but...
Yeah.
Okay, hard, but fair enough. Give him a round of applause. Dave. You've got 12 lights remaining. 12 of our girls are interested in you. And now it's whittling time. Now, the power is in your hands. You have to get rid of 10 girls and leave 2 lights remaining for our final round. Pick the 2 girls you'd most like to see in the very end of this game. David, away you go. Turn off 10 lights, leave 2 on. Who should it go for, audience?
Come on.
Whittle it down to just 2. Who's he going to turn off, folks? Come on, audience. Give him a hand. Who's he going to go for? Hey, David, you have to turn off some lights. Karen's gone. There's only 7 more. Come on, David, audience, give him a hand. Adele is still on, Ali's still on, Lou's still on, oh, Alessandra, Aoife, Baya, Lal. Gone. Tracy's light is still on, who should he go for? Come on, audience, give him a hand. Still on. You have to lose 5 more, David, any time tonight. Lou's gone. Orla, Sandra. Sandra's gone. So Orla's still interested. 3 more lights to go, David. Come on, man. Gone. Aoife's light is still on. Adele, Ali, Orla. And 1 more light still to go. David, 1 more light to go. Get rid of 1 more for me, please, and leave 1 light remaining. Oh, it's gone. Come back here. Give him a round of applause.
That's tough.
It is. It's tough.
That's tough.
God, hearing the boys complain about having so many girls interested in them, it's ridiculous.
Tough.
It is tough. Yeah, I'll have to take your word for that, though. That was some great whittling, though. We are down to our final two girls. It's Aoife and Idel. Why did you leave those lights on?
Just look at them. They're beautiful.
Two very beautiful girls. That's so sweet. Yeah, okay. To help you choose between our two girls on who you're going to take out on a date tonight, you need to find out a little bit more about them by asking our two lovely ladies one question. Ask away, sir. And good luck.
Okay. Right, girls, I have two sisters, so I know that women like to shop. Just a little bit, okay? But if you had to choose between shopping and sex, which one would you choose? And why?
Okay. Girls, this is the most difficult question you've been asked all day. Aoife!
Well, my family are watching this show, so I'm going to have to say shopping.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay, fair enough.
And Idel?
My family are also watching the show. But to hell with them. Sex!
Yeah! Davey, it's between Aoife and Idel. Get out there and turn one off and take one out. But before you do, I need to remind you, one of our girls does voiceovers for cartoons. One of our girls does voiceovers for cartoons. Get out there and turn off one of those lights and take one of our girls out tonight. Who should he go for?
Yeah.
Audience! Aoife or Idel? Aoife or Idel? Aoife? Come on, folks, come on. You have to turn off one. Kill one and take one out. Well done, you two. Are you happy?
Yes.
Yes, smile on his face. Are you happy?
Happy?
It looks like you're on shopping now, Div.
Brilliant.
I need to tell you as well that Idel was the girl who does voiceovers for cartoons.
Mm.
And guys, you're heading off on the date of your dreams tonight. Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name. Which is good, because as usual, you two are the only ones who'd be seen dead in...
Shifter!
That is over. Free. Yeah.
Well, the main thing for me leaving my light on for him was that he was tall, he was handsome, he could sing. Not great, but he could sing a little bit, and he was perfect. And he'll bring me shopping.
Well, it's a tough choice, but down to the last two, I just went for her because she had a little cheeky smile, and she was gorgeous and just liked what she was wearing. So that was the main reason.
Another great result. Last time on Take Me Out, Sinead went out on a date with Alan, and let's see how they got on.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
My first impression was very attractive looking. Seems like good fun. Her answers on the show were very good, very positive.
When I met Alan, I thought he's a very attractive guy, a good dresser, and seems pretty nice.
He's nice and chatty, which is what I'm looking for. Just talked about where we're from, what she does in life. She likes to travel a lot as well, which is good. I love traveling.
Day went really well. There was no awkward silences. Like, run like a girl. I know I am
you
a girl.
Are.
But, you know, like a real,
The
legs kind of kick out to the side.
Normally I go for a small blonde girls. That would be normally my type, but I was very attracted to her when I first saw her out on stage.
I found his smile very attractive. And his dress sense is very appealing.
I've already asked Sinead for a number and we've made plans to meet up at a later stage.
I think Alan likes to party, but I like to party too, so maybe we can party together.
Good news there, looking good. Okay, folks, that weather isn't going to talk about itself, so we'll see you after this. Welcome back. In the last round, we matched David and Aoife. Well, now that means we've got room for a brand new friend. Everyone say hello to Nuala. Hey, Nuala.
Hi, Foley.
How are you, missus? What are you looking for in a man and take me out tonight?
I'm just going to say one simple thing is all I want, but it's very hard to find in Ireland. I just want a guy with brown eyes.
Brown eyes?
That's it. Simple.
We can do that. We can do that. Can't we do that, yeah? Yeah. We'll sort you out, Nuala. Welcome to the show. All right, it's time to meet our next man. Girls, are you ready? Let's do this thing. Open that throttle and bring on the boy. Show, sir. Nice entrance. It's over to you.
Hi, girls. I'm Paul, and I'm from Cork.
Hey! Paul from Cork. Ladies, you turned on or you turned off? Oh, that's not a bad result at all. Give him a round of applause. Okay. You have nothing to complain about with 23 lights still on 23 beautiful ladies, yes, and all of them interested in you. You're still in the game, and remember, girls, if you think this boy is fine, then let your light shine. Take a look.
I know Paul through Ultimate Frisbee in UCC. I've known him for about 2 years, so, and he's quite a guy. He's probably the biggest ladies man I've ever met in my life.
He thinks himself as a ladies man, but he's not really. He's got a soft, smooth centre. He's a nice guy.
He knows how to talk to girls, and he's just really, really good fun. He never is nervous or anything like that around girls.
He has a thing for Michael Bublé. He's his favourite artist.
He wears his Michael Bublé hot pants to training all the time. They're black, and they have Michael Bublé across the back in pink with lips on it.
Yeah! Polly, you lost 16 girls in that round with 7 still remaining. Are they your lucky number 7? Let's go out and have a talk with a few of our girls. Nuala, new girl, you turned off in that round. What did you see that you didn't like?
Well, mommy's boy thing is bad enough, but ladies' man as well. And, like, a lot of mommy's boys, they can't find anyone as good as their mommy who'll cook and clean for them, and I'm definitely not going to do that.
Oh, OK. No commitment there. Helen, your light's off as well. Why?
Nothing turns me on more than a Cork accent. But the ladies, man, I've been cheated on too many times to take the risk. I'm sorry.
Oh.
How? How could anyone cheat on you?
Oh! Yeah, yeah. More of that, more of that. Latanya, your light is off. Why?
Yeah. I tell you one thing. You're really, really good looking. I loved the tune you came down. I love Wham. Right, yeah. We won't even get started on that. But you just totally disappointed me with your mate who said you're a ladies, man. I totally would have left my light on otherwise. Like, seriously, would have left
ex-mate.
Ex-mate. Ex-mate, now. Yeah. Speaking to him again. Drop from the Facebook friends list and everything. Yeah, yeah. And Ali, your light's still on as well.
Yeah, loved the tune when it came out. That got me from the start. The rest of your VT, other than the ladies' man, was really good.
Yeah.
But I'll just leave you that one thing. You say one more thing and you're out. But I'm loving it so far.
One more round, one more chance from Ali. Okay, one more chance. All right, Paulie, you got 7 girls remaining as we head into our third and final round. One more chance for our girls to turn off their lights. The question is, will they? You've got to impress to leave with a date. You got 30 seconds to impress our girls. Get flirty for 30. And girls, if you're feeling nothing, hit that button.
All right, so girls, as you can see, I'm not a typical guy. I like to try things outside the box, like ultimate frisbee, skimboarding, surfing. I've skydived in Australia. But I also like to challenge myself with things like triathlons. And I kayaked across Ireland 3 years ago for cancer research. So I definitely need a girl who can keep me on my toes. And if you find yourself breathless on a date with me, Mr. Lifeguard, I'll bring you back to life.
Seven still remaining, Paul. Well done. That means he's got a date. This is the best bit, because now, sir, now the power is in your hands. It's time to whittle. You gotta get out there and whittle it down to just 2 ladies. Turn all the rest of the lights off, leave 2 girls still standing. It's time we had ourselves a whittling. Away you go, Paul. Right, audience, give him a hand. Who should he turn? Ali, Karen. Oh, you gotta turn off 5 lights for me. 5 lights. She's got to turn off. Sandra's there. She's gone. Audience, who should be turning off? Come on, give him a hand. Give him a bit of help. It's not looking good for me. Oh, no! Between Sarah Jane, fire. Two more to go. Come on, boy, turn off two lights for me. Turn off two lights. Arlene is gone. Karen's gone. Give her a round of applause. Come and join me, my friend. We've got Sarah Jane, we've got fire. Two beautiful ladies. It's not going to be an easy decision for you to make. They know a lot about you, sir. But you don't know that much about them. You've got one question, and one question only, to put to our two ladies, and depending on how they answer, you decide on who you're taking out tonight. Paul, take it away and good luck.
Right, so, girls, if you were an alien and you could abduct anybody in the world, who would you pick and why?
Oh! A very deep answer, a very deep question there, Paul. Sarah Jane, if you were an alien and you could abduct anyone in the world, who would you abduct and why?
Well, of course it happens to be Paul. How we can surf the sky together and look at the stars. Ah!
And fire.
Oh, God, mine's awful. Oh, don't hate me for this, but it just popped into my head. I'd probably abduct my worst enemy and torture them. I know, it's awful.
Abduct you? All right, OK. And do you have someone in mind for that fire?
Yeah.
You do? All right, God love them. Right, OK. We've got a pair of space cadets here, ready to abduct someone. It's between Sarah Jane and Fire, and it's going to be a difficult decision for you to make, sir. I do need to tell you, before you make that decision, that one of our girls plays tricks on guys with her twin sister. Get out there and turn one off and take one out. Paul, good luck. Audience, who should he go for? Sarah Jane and Paul, you guys. Paul, are you happy?
Yeah, very happy, yeah.
Sarah Jane?
Yeah, very happy.
Delighted. Speechless, delighted. Guys, before you head off on your date, Paul, I need to tell you, the fire is the girl that's constantly playing tricks with her twin on people. And you're heading off on your date tonight. You're going somewhere you can see all the stars. That's because there's a massive hole in the roof of Shifters! Off you go, take it easy, guys.
Crack, right, isn't it?
I'm really glad he picked me. We've got so much in common, and yeah, we're going to shoot for the stars tonight.
And that's that. That's all we've got time for tonight. We sent Seán and Lorna off on their date, as well as Michael and Mairead, David and Aoife, and Paul and Sarah Jane. We can't wait to see how well they got on or didn't get on. And will the rest of our girls find love? Well, I'm not going to stop trying until I get all of these lovely ladies a guy. I'll see you next time on Take Me Out.